Good afternoon, everyone. I'd like to thank you very much for taking a few minutes. I'm Taku Izumi from Fujitsu Limited. I'll be talking about the ironic story of filling the gap between bare metal and virtual machine. My English is rather limited, and I'd appreciate your bearing with me. I'd be glad to answer any question at the end of or after my presentation. Now, let's begin. This presentation consists of three parts. First, I'll outline OpenStack ironic overview. Then, I'm going to talk about new future in Newton. And finally, I'm going to talk about under development and future plan. In this part, I'm going to outline OpenStack ironic overview. Before getting into OpenStack ironic overview, I'd like to talk about why bare metal provisioning. As background, prior to the cloud, customers operate their workload on on-premise servers. As cloud becomes popular, customers try to migrate their workload to cloud in order to maximize the efficiency. However, some workloads cannot migrate to cloud due to hypervisor overhead. For example, IO intensive workloads don't suit to switch to VM, so it's hard to migrate. Workloads that cannot be migrated to cloud still have to be operated on on-premise servers. So customers needed to double manage on-premise servers and cloud. One of the solutions of this problem is the bare metal provisioning on the cloud. Of course, bare metal servers have no hypervisor overhead, so customers can migrate their old workloads from on-premise to cloud environment and enjoy merit of cloud. Such as flexible, scalable, and efficient. That's why we Fujitsu considered bare metal provisioning service is important. Fujitsu puts much effort in ironic quality and feature enhancement. Our goal is to achieve unified operation. What is unified operation? Unified operation means customers can manage VM and bare metal servers in a similar fashion, and customers can enjoy cloud functionality transparently. All that you can do against virtual machine should be also capable against bare metal servers. OpenStack has already achieved bare metal provisioning by using ironic service. We want to achieve unified operation in OpenStack. However, because OpenStack started with virtualization technology, we think that there are still gaps between VM and bare metal servers. I'll cover these gaps at second and third topic. Before moving on to the next topic, I'd like to overview OpenStack ironic. In the next few slides, I'll illustrate OpenStack ironic. OpenStack ironic is a service to deploy bare metal servers. Ironic is to bare metal servers what Libert is to VM. Customers can deploy bare metal servers by using Nova API, like virtual machines. In case customers want to use bare metal servers, all they have to do is to select flavors for bare metal servers on deployment. By using this, bare metal can be deployed instead of virtual machine. In this slide, I'd like to share with you the components of ironic briefly. Ironic consists of three components. First one is ironic API. Ironic API is REST API entry points that only administrator can use. Second one is ironic conductor. Ironic conductor is an ironic core component. This invokes the driver's interface and manages the database. Last one is driver. Driver is a mechanism to abstract differences among bare metal servers. It controls the BMC via out of bounds. Server vendors provide drivers to control servers. For example, Fujitsu provides IRMC driver for Fujitsu primary servers. I'd like to illustrate the deployment procedure. There are three differences depending on there are some differences depending on drivers and setting. Overview is as follows. First, ironic powers on a bare metal servers. Next, the bare metal server gets a deployment image. This figure shows the case where Ironic uses a pixie boot method for deployment. By this method, the bare metal server gets a deployment image from the TFTP server, which is prepared by the administrator. Booted by the deployment image, the bare metal server prepares iSCSI target and sends a notification to Ironic. Then, Ironic copies user OS image to the bare metal server by using iSCSI. After copying, Ironic reboots the bare metal server. Then, the bare metal server will boot from the user image and it's ready. Bare metal servers can be deployed by Ironic service like this way. However, as I said earlier, there are some gaps to be filled between VM and BM. I'll show you some gaps in the following parts. In this part, I'll be talking about new future in Newton. These are gaps in Newton cycle. In Newton cycle, network isolation and serial console for bare metal servers can be achieved. Network isolation feature is creating provide LAN among bare metal servers and VMs for each tenant. And serial console feature is a serial console access to bare metal servers. I'll show you each of them in detail. In the next few slides, I'll explain network isolation for bare metal servers achieved in Newton cycle. This slide shows the status of network isolation feature as of Mitaka. In case of virtual machine, network isolation can be done with such as VLAN, VXLAN, GRE, or GNE EV technology. However, in case of bare metal server, network isolation cannot be achieved. This means all bare metal servers can be deployed in the same network, cannot have multi-tenancy, flat network only. So, no network isolation for bare metal servers. This slide indicates the mechanism to achieve network isolation. In case of virtual machine, network path leaving from the virtual machine to the external network is like light figures. Network isolation can be achieved by configuring VLAN to OpenVSH in hypervisor layer. In case of bare metal servers, there's no hypervisor layer, so network path directly connect to the external network. So it is necessary to make VLAN configuration against physical switch port directory. This is achieved by Neutron ML2 plugins. And furthermore, network flipping is necessary. I'll explain network flipping at the next slide. Network flip means switching from management network to tenant network. Why is necessary? The reason is bare metal servers need to be access to the resources on management network during deployment. The resources in management network is ionic conductor, deploy image, and root image. Management network sometimes called as provisioning network. The procedure of deployment is as follows. First, connect to the management network, then retrieving deploy image and boot image. And then finally, switch to the tenant network for network isolation. The same applies cleanup sequence. The bare metal servers needs to connect to management network once during cleanup. So far, we'll be looking at network isolation. Next is the serial console. Serial console connection on bare metal servers has been achieved in Newton cycle. This feature enables customer to connect to serial port of bare metal servers. This is very useful because we can troubleshoot by using serial console in case of boot failure before configuring OS's network setting and network problem. Serial console is one of the essential features for enterprise. This slide indicates the mechanism to achieve serial console. In case of virtual machines, revert in hypervisor layer provides a way to access virtual machine's serial port. However, customers cannot access directly. It is necessary a kind of proxy for customer to access hypervisor. And that is the Nova serial proxy. Nova serial proxy runs on the same server as Horizon. The same is true for bare metal servers. Proxy is necessary to access bare metal serial console. Customer can access serial console of bare metal servers by going through Nova serial proxy via Horizon. Various implementation has been proposed, but finally, Fujitsu and NEC proposed the method to use Nova serial proxy as it is. And this method has been accepted. SOCAT and IPM tools relay the serial connection between Nova serial proxy and BMC. Serial console of bare metal server has been achieved by this approach. In this part, I talked about new feature in Newton. Some gaps have been filled in Newton cycle. However, there are other remaining gaps. In this part, I'd like to share with you under development and future plans. This slide shows the remaining gaps between VM and bare metal to be filled. In this topic, I divided remaining gaps into some categories. I'll explain them respectively. First, I'll cover glacial shutdown and graphical console. Glacial shutdown is a feature to shut off the server properly. Instead of forcing shutdown, this feature enables power off bare metal servers after OS shutdown procedure. This is achieved by using ACPI SCI. This is the same mechanism as when pushing power button. In case of virtual machine, ACPI SCI can be injected to virtual machine by revert in hypervisor layer. When customer calls shutdown API, Nova invokes revert API to inject ACPI SCI. restless shutdown has been already done for virtual machine. However, in case of bare metal servers, graceless shutdown has not been achieved yet. Currently, Ironic does not support graceless shutdown. When customer calls shutdown API, Ironic tries to force power off bare metal servers. In order to achieve graceless shutdown for bare metal, it is necessary to inject ACPI-SCI against bare metal servers. Most BMC already has capability to inject ACPI-SCI, so the remaining thing is to create a mechanism for Ironic issue a request to BMC. In order to achieve this, we propose the implementation to use IPMI power command and now development. This feature is expected to complete it in Okata cycle. Next one is graphical console feature. Graphical console is, needless to say, common interface for user to operate machine. In case of virtual machine, implementation is very similar to the case of a serial console. Graphical console is achieved using VNC protocol. Customer can access graphical console of virtual machine by going through NovaNoVNC proxy. Serial console feature for bare metal has been achieved in Newton cycle. However, currently, there is no graphical console for bare metal server. This will be discussed at this summit. Next is network-related gaps. I'll cover network redundancy, multiple network support, and security group. Network redundancy, such as a link aggregation, is essential for enterprise. However, network redundancy configuration for bare metal servers is not supported yet. In case of virtual machine, network redundancy is achieved at hypervisor layer by bonding host physical network in computer node. In case of bare metal, there's no hypervisor, so it's a bit difficult to achieve network redundancy. In order to support network redundancy configuration for bare metal servers, it is necessary to make a bonding configuration at the bare metal server. Information to configure teaming is retrieved Nova config driver. At the same time, it is also necessary to configure link aggregation at L2 switch, so this requires Neutron plugin to configure L2 switch. This is under developing. There are still gaps, related gaps. Next one is multiple network support. In case of virtual machine, of course, virtual machine can be configured with multiple networks. As this left figure shows, virtual machine can connect not only business LAN 1, but to business LAN 2. However, in case of bare metal, currently, bare metal servers cannot be configured with multiple networks. Bare metal server can have only one network. This means there's a limit of network configuration for bare metal servers. Next network-related gap is security group. What is security group? Security group is packet filtering rules that can be applied to each network port. This is popular technology for virtual machine. Multiple security groups can be applied. Filtering can be achieved outside of virtual machine instance, so firewall rule need not be set with each virtual machine. Now that multi-tenancy network isolation for bare metal has been achieved, security group for bare metal should increase in importance. This slide indicates the mechanism to achieve security group. In case of virtual machine, security group is achieved by configuring IP table rules at Linux bridges in hypervisor layer. In case of bare metal server, there is no hypervisor, so it cannot be take the same approach as virtual machine. In order to support security groups for bare metal servers, it is necessary to configure access control list setting at L2 switch. This will be achieved by Neutron ML2 vendor plugin. Fujitsu will achieve security groups for bare metal servers in Okata cycle with combination of Fujitsu's L2 switch and Neutron ML2 vendor plugin. So far, I talked about network-related gaps. Next gap I'll cover is storage-related gaps. Remaining storage-related gap is cinder volume attachment to bare metal servers. In case of virtual machine can use cinder volume. Hypervisor connects to a remote volume directory, then attach it to virtual machine as a local disk. Virtual machine don't care about the difference between host local and remote volume. Virtual machine don't have to be special things to use cinder volume. However, in case of bare metal servers, there's no hypervisor. In order to use remote volume managed by cinder, bare metal server directly connects to remote volume. As this light figure shows, ionic conductor passes the connection information to bare metal servers, then configure some setting. This implementation is under development. When using cinder volume, we need further consideration, that is storage isolation. Storage resources is for customers, so it needs to separate the access to storage on per-user basis. In order to achieve storage isolation, VLAN for iSCSI-SAN, zoning forced affinity for FC-SAN will be used. This is under discussion. Will Fujitsu achieve this in Okata cycle? Final gaps are availability and maintainability ones. I'll cover inject NMI, rescue mode, and failover instances. Inject NMI is a feature to inject NMI. NMI stands for non-maskable interrupts against instances. The behavior of handling NMI depends on OS configuration. In general, it is set to panic OS and collect memory dumps when receive unknown NMI. Memory dumps is very useful for troubleshooting of OS hang and storing. For example, for enterprise field, it is necessary to investigate root cause of problem. Memory dump is essential. So inject NMI feature is important. In case of virtual machine, revert in hypervisor layer has a feature to inject NMI against virtual machine, and Nova have already supported this feature. But in case of bare metal servers, currently this feature is under developing. Solution will be like this light figure. Most BMC has capability to inject NMI against servers. So the remaining things is to create a mechanism for Ionic issue a request to BMC. In order to achieve this, we propose the implementation to use IPMI power command. This is expected to achieve in Okada cycle. Next one is rescue mode. In general, rescue mode is a feature to boot a system with installation media when system cannot boot properly due to some reasons, such as disk failure. This allows you to get a chance to repair the broken system. In case of virtual machine, there's already a feature for rescuing system. Nova Rescue provides a mechanism to repair broken disk. When VM can't boot properly, by using Nova Rescue, another virtual machine is provided and broken disk is attached to its virtual machine as a secondary disk. Customer can get a chance to repair disks or salvage data. In case of bare metal servers, currently Nova Rescue is not supported, but specification has already merged so that we can use Nova Rescue against bare metal servers. Implementation will be as follows. When bare metal servers cannot boot properly due to such a disk failure, by using Nova Rescue, bare metal server is rebooted and boots with RAM disk image. Customer can get a chance to repair it. This is also expected to achieve in Okada cycle. And the last one is failover instances feature. In case of virtual machine, needless to say, virtual machine have no chance of malfunction. But host physical machine that virtual machines are running on may go wrong. If host goes wrong, virtual machines on its host will involve collisional damage. Nova provides API to evacuate virtual machines to another host. This enables customers' business continuation on virtual machine. In case of bare metal servers are physical servers, so they might go wrong. In order for customers' business in continuation, failover feature of broken bare metal servers is also necessary. In order to achieve bare metal servers failover, we need a mechanism to take over all of the environment to another bare metal server. Fujitsu has already submitted specification of this feature. Unfortunately, it is not much yet. So far, I talked about remaining gaps. Let me summarize my presentation. This presentation consists of three parts. First, I'll outline OpenStack Ionic overview. In this part, I talked about why bare metal provisioning and Ionic overview. Then, I talked about new feature in Newton. I covered network isolation and serial console feature of bare metal servers. And finally, I talked about under development and future plan. We've been looking at remaining gaps to be filled between virtual machine and bare metal, and current status. That's all my presentation. Thank you. Any question? Okay, thank you very much.